Hello everybody, my name is Zohir Chaudhary and right now we'll talk about urbanization and growth of megacities. Urbanization is a dynamic process of growth and change in cities, generally featuring population growth and often also featuring expanding urban boundaries, changes in density, and demographic changes such as greater diversity. Early cities were established along trade routes or at points where the movement of goods shifted from one mode of transportation to another, such as at river and ocean ports. The main form of travel was walking, so people needed to live near where they worked, traded, and prayed. Compact high-density settlement was the norm. The need to move goods and people locally led to the development of street networks for use by wagons and carriages. With the start of industrialization, there was an influx of manufacturing jobs and workers into cities. Population of London grew to 6 million and of New York to 3.5 million at that time. These fast-growing cities featured crowded, squalid conditions and inadequate infrastructure, facilitating the spread of diseases such as tuberculosis and typhoid. Later on, migration from Europe and Africa to the US and from southern US states to northern US states accelerated urban growth in the US. Development of potable water supplies, sewage systems, waste management, as well as other technological development led to the development of railroads, streetcars, and private automobiles. This enabled urban sprawl, especially in the US and Australia after the Second World War. Over the last few decades, urbanization in low and middle income countries is growing faster than in developed countries. By 2010, the world's urban population surpassed its rural population for the first time. Urbanization is increasing since people are moving from rural to urban locations. Can you think the reason why people would want to leave the comfort of their rural homes and move to urban areas? Yeah, think about it. So, megacities are urban areas with a population of 10 million and more. And in here, we are showing many cities who have 10 million or more people, and the projected population by 2030. North America will continue having three megacities, Mexico City, New York, and Los Angeles, but Asia will have most of the megacities, as you can see in this map. The source of this data is from the United Nations World Urbanization Prospects Report, published in 2014. In this same report, the UN is projecting that by 2030, the world will have 41 megacities with more than 10 million inhabitants. Tokyo will still remain the world's largest megacity, but Delhi and Shanghai will have populations slightly less than Tokyo. Here, you can visualize the expansive concrete and lights that characterizes expansive megacities such as Tokyo. Now, a critical thinking question. Can you think of environmental problems that may arise in megacities? Typical environmental problems that megacities face are rising air pollution from increased private and public transportation needs, as well as from industrialization, rising water pollution from sewage, stormwater drainage, and other human activities that are typical in large urban areas, rising soil and groundwater pollution from waste disposal in landfill and overextraction of groundwater resources, as well as increased health effects and environmental effects from overcrowding, which in turn can lead to devastating effects when vector-borne transmission occurs, such as Ebola outbreaks, or Zika virus outbreak, etc. And finally, another problem that arises from megacities is when population increase very fast, which is typical in current megacities in developing countries, infrastructure to support the growing population cannot keep up. Thus, all problems are magnified even more. So, concept check. A megacity is a city with a population of C, 10 million people. All right. Thank you, and I will see you all later. Mm-hmm.